What's up, Dons? I'm Max.
And I'm Preston.
This week is the last full week seniors will be on campus, as well as the last episode of CCTV fully produced by seniors.
Seniors, good luck on your final exams today. Semester final exams are mandatory attendance days, so make sure y'all pull up.
There will be a mandatory graduation practice from 12:55 p.m. to 2:20 p.m. You'll receive your caps, gowns, academic regalia, and graduation tickets.
Also, seniors, you can pick up your free Cathedral Catholic Class of 2023 yard signs at the Colby Center front desk.
Don't want to miss out on these epic signs that look super chill in your front yard.
Yo, Max, what are you majoring in?
Free Deerlands photography. Freelance cooking with a minor in bakery. Blacksmithing and cooking. Actually majoring in the political science as well as a minor.
In English? Or word pronunciation.
That's crazy.
Let's go off to Catalina to find out what our seniors are majoring in.
Hi, Dons. The school year is coming to an end, and seniors will be moving on to college. Let's talk to some seniors about what major they chose for college and how this will help them for their future careers.
Oh, I'm going to be attending Cal State San Marcos, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
I'm going to Cal Poly San Luis Obispo.
I'm going to UCI.
I'm going to the University of Oregon.
What major did you choose for college, and why did you pick it?
I chose a bachelor's in science in biochem because, you know, biochemistry is really interesting. You get to learn about organic compounds and even the chemical makeup of life, and I found that really cool. And then eventually I'll go to one of the UCs for medical school, and I don't know, I'm thinking of maybe surgery, anesthesiology, cardiology, or even just a regular family physician, but that's down the road, but I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a lot of fun.
So I'm going into Cal Poly as a business administration major, and I picked it for a few reasons, but mainly because it's such a broad major, so there's many different pathways you can go down. And what's nice about Cal Poly is they have like a bunch of different focuses you can go into. So there's finance, real estate, accounting, and so by your sophomore you can pick one of those. So I'm just gonna go and do it with open mind and see where it leads me. So yeah.
I'm going into international studies. The main reason is because I grew up in a multicultural, multiracial background. So it's always been a part of me, and that's kind of developed into me just loving to learn new languages, and I love learning about cultures, and so naturally I'm going into international studies so I can further my love for cultures and languages.
I chose political science with a focus on international relations. Back in middle school, I got a bunch of posts about other countries and flags and stuff on my explore page, and I started trying to learn all my flags, all my capitals, etc., etc. And so I've always found that kind of thing interesting. Both my parents were in politics, so.
Learning what your own skills and talents are is a huge part of becoming an adult. It might be hard at first, but eventually everyone learns what kinds of things they're good at. Then you can use those gifts to benefit the rest of the world. Now, back to the studio.
Stay in school, dogs!
The last day to view the student art show is today, so slide over and check it out.
Also, seniors will receive their yearbook during graduation practice today or on Monday, May 22nd in the Academic Center.
For underclassmen, you'll be allowed to pick up your yearbook in the Academic Center on Wednesday, May 24th or Thursday, May 25th.
Hi, I'm Julianne. I'm the editor-in-chief of the yearbook.
Hi, I'm Tal, and I'm the design editor of the yearbook.
This year's yearbook contains a special feature called Yearbook Plus. You can scan this icon to store your personal photos for 30 plus years. This personalizes your yearbook.
Seniors, come pick up your yearbooks today at grad practice, and freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, you can pick them up the following Wednesdays and Thursdays at break, lunch, and before school.
There might be a special surprise for this year's yearbook, so you want to come get it as soon as possible.
All are welcome to a free movie viewing of the true story about Bryson Newman, Miracle in Manchester, on Wednesday, May 24th at 6 p.m. in the Guadalupe Theater.
An RSVP link can be found in the May 12th newsletter.
Now off to Emma for her final senior standout.
Hey Dons, it's Emma here, and I'm back with my very last student standout. Naturally, I had to choose the prom king,
Michael Peterson.
For the last time, let's do some rapid fire questions. Michael, what has your favorite memory been at Cathedral?
Definitely the Kairos retreats.
And who was your favorite teacher you've had over the past 4 years?
Mr. Cara.
What college are you going to, and what is your major?
University of Tennessee at Knoxville and communications.
If you could give advice to any juniors going into senior year, what would you say?
Just enjoy your last year at Cathedral. It's a great time. Just have a lot of fun.
What is your favorite subject in school?
Academic coaching or lunch.
If you had to choose one thing that you're most excited for after high school, what would it be?
Just the next four at college and just having fun at college.
Thank you so much for being my very last student standout. It was so much fun getting to know Michael.
Hey Dons,
I'm Emma.
And welcome back to CCTV Sports. It has been the highlight of my 4 years here to be a part of the CCTV team. I will miss recapping sports, anchoring and sharing events on campus, and bringing you student standouts every week. With that being said, for the last time, let's get into this week's sports updates. Boys volleyball is absolutely killing it. They had two huge wins this past week. They won Open Division CIF 3-0 against Scripps Ranch last Saturday and won the first round of Division I state playoffs 3-1 against MiraCosta on Tuesday. Good luck, boys, as you continue on into the state semis. Moving on to baseball, baseball won their last two games against Saints 9-1 and 4-3. Their record is now 19-8. Great job, boys. Girls lacrosse won their playoff game against La Costa Canyon 12-7. They are currently 19-4 and are continuing to kill it in playoffs. Good luck, girls. Girls softball won their last game against Mission Bay 11-3. They are currently 19-8-1 and plan to improve their record with more games next week. Great job, Lady Dons. The golf team just won CIF last week. Huge shout out to Trevor Cox, who won the individual CIF for all of San Diego. The team starts CIF regionals next week in Los Angeles. Congratulations, boys, on your huge win. That's it for my last sports update. Now off to Max with his highlight reel.
What's up, y'all? It's Max. Welcome to your weekly Cathedral Catholic Television program. For the last time, I'll be on here doing a sports special, and I wanted to look back at all the funniest moments that we've had on this broadcast. Check it out.
Hey, Dons. Hey, Dons.
Well, I started about 5 years ago, and I...
Teams, and there's nobody coming up that is difficult.
When he lifts with us at 5 a.m. in the morning, it's just inspiring.
All right, I'm here with Big Wales. Let's get this.
Yes, sir. Chase the rainbow.
Moving back on the sideline. NBA...
Let's go home!
Oh! All right, I'm here with Johnny, 5-star LSU power forward.
What's up, Dons? It's Father.
And Max. I'm interviewing Dago Legends, who also happen to be on the varsity basketball team.
Luke Tadros, when you're on the perimeter, what's your go-to move to get buckets?
Usually I go between and then behind. And 360, I call it the TRB brother.
Paul Colucci, also known as Muscles. I mean, how does benching 225 for 8 in your boxing career help you on the basketball court?
You know, I work out with my brother every day, J2. And my boxing career and benching 225, like you said, definitely has helped my range a lot because I've been able to shoot from a lot farther away from the basket.
Nick Waka Flocka Flame, often considered the most improved player on the rugby pitch. What'd you do in the offseason to get better?
All right, so what I did in the offseason was pretty simple. Worked out a lot. Did a lot of football practices.
That's an air ball.
Hey!
Back out to Adam. History final.
Get
it! Hey, Dons.
Hi, Ben.
What's up, Ben?
Hi, Ben.
It's that time of the year again. With great grief and sorrow, I'll be saying goodbye to CCTV. It's time to also look back and enjoy all the beautiful memories I've made. I got myself here with me. I'm gonna ask him some questions. What's your favorite memory at CCHS? All the relationships I've built, all the friends I've made, and you know, all the teachers are very supportive and very kind. The community here, and just everything that the school has offered me. What's your favorite CCTV package you've made?
There's a lot of packages I've made that's very memorable to me. Definitely my first football package, my first package ever. The FIFA with Father Martin package was really fun. Interviewing the soccer team.
That was a good one.
When the package when I served, the Chinese New Year package, anchoring with my homie Max, and the Homeboy Industries package was really memorable because I got to go to LA for that. So a lot of good memories.
What's your funniest CCTV experience?
The funniest experience is definitely when Mr. A is gone, we put up a beat in the classroom and freestyle over it. I'll be at UC Riverside. I'll be close to San Diego, so hopefully I get chances to come back and visit. You know, fortunately, I'll be close.
Thank you, Emma.
After 4 years at Cathedral Catholic, it is time for us seniors to move on to the next chapter of our lives.
This has been Max
and Preston
for the first and last time on CCTV.
We will catch you guys later.
From the seniors of CCTV,
we are signing out.
Good luck on finals.
And have a great rest of the school year.
Seniors, enjoy your last day of high school.
Thank you for watching CCTV.